May God, in the highest, are on earth peace and goodwill towards men. We praise you, we bless you, we worship you, we glorify you, we give thanks to you for your great glory. O Lord, heavenly King, God, the Father Almighty, O Lord, the only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit. O Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, who takes away the sin of the world, receive forever, takes away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You who take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You who sit at the right hand of God the Father, have mercy on us. We want our holy, you alone, our Lord, O Jesus Christ, and the glory of God the Father. Amen. Every day I will give thanks to you and praise your name forever, even unto the ages of ages. Lord, you have been a refuge from generation to generation. I said, Lord, be merciful to me, and heal my soul, for I sinned against you. Lord, I have led you, teach me to do your will, for you are my God. With you is the fountain of life, and in your light we shall see light. O continue your mercy upon those who know you. Vouchsafe, O Lord, that we kept this day without sin. Blessed are you, Lord, God of our fathers, and praised and glorified is your name forever. Amen. Let your mercy, O Lord, be upon us as we have hoped in you. Blessed are you, O Lord, teach me your statutes. Blessed are you, O Master, make me to understand your statutes. Blessed are you, O Holy One, enlighten me with your statutes. Your mercy, O Lord, endures forever. Despise not the works of your hands. To you is due praise, to you is due song, to you is due glory, to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen.
You were nailed to the tree, granting life to us. We ever honor you as Savior and Lord.
We were filled in the morning with your mercy, O Lord. We rejoiced and were glad all the days. We were glad for the days in which you humbled us and for the years in which we so labeled. Look down upon your servants and upon your works and guide their children.
Through your cross, O Christ, angels and all mankind will become one flock and one church. Heaven and earth rejoice, O Lord, glory to you.
And let this wonder, O Lord our God, be upon us and guide away the works of our hands, yea, away the works of our hands.
No tribulation, nor threat, or hunger, persecution, fire, sword, or savage beast could separate the holy martyrs from God. They were bound by his love and lived as exiles in this world. Their suffering has won them a glorious prize. They inherited the heavenly kingdom, where they ceaselessly pray for our souls.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Amen.
The Church of God, universal martyrs, have beheld your struggles in days of old, to days adorned with splendor, celebrating with faith on the day of your memorial, O service of office, wearing this chain and clothes of your divine necks and mockery as well for adornment. You have been given heavenly glory and unending blessedness, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Then the unblemished lamb beheld the lamb led of his own will as a man to the slaughter. She said, weeping, do not now hasten to weeping, childless, who gave you birth, O Christ. What is this that you have done, O deliverer of all? Yet I can be endured by your escape goodness, which passes understanding and counting. O you who love mankind, it is good to give thanks to the Lord, to sing praises to your name, O God, to proclaim your love at daybreak, and your faithfulness all through the night. O God, who is mighty, who is born, who have mercy on us. O God, who is mighty, who is born, who have mercy on us. O God, who is mighty, who is born, who have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. O Lord, from eternity, have mercy on us. Lord, cleanse us from our sins. Master, pardon our transgressions. Holy One, give us the mark of these for your name's sake. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil, Lord.
For the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us.
Amen. Your holy martyr, Sergius and Baptist, O Lord, hear their suffering, have received incorruptible crowns from you, our God. For having those graciously willed their adversaries and shattered the powerless boldness of demons, hear their intercession and save our souls. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Magnify you, O Lord, and help us with cry out, you are the mountain from which the stone was indescribably hewn, which destroyed the gates of hell.
Preserve, O Lord God, the holy and pure faith and pious and Orthodox Christians, with this monastery and this countryside to the ages of ages. Amen. More honorable than the cherubim, the beyond him, more glorious than the seraphim, without defilement, who gave birth to God, the Lord, to their focus, remaining rightly. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. To the prayers of our Holy Father, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us. Amen.
So lift your heads, to give thanks to the Lord, to
Spirit, now and ever and unto ages. Amen. Thank you. Let us attend. The Lord said, why do you call me Lord, Lord, and not do the things which I say? Whoever comes to me and hears my sayings and does them, I will show you whom he is like. He is like a man building a house who dug deep and laid the foundation on the rock. And when the flood arose, the stream beat vehemently against that house and could not shake it, for it was founded on the rock. But he who heard and did nothing is like a man who built a house on the earth without a foundation, against which the stream beat vehemently, and immediately it fell, and the ruin of that house was great. Now when he had concluded all his sayings in the hearing of the people, he entered Capernaum.
Describe our state of mind right now is that we really like wisdom a lot. We love to hear clever sayings. And in fact, if you look a little bit, you can go on the internet and you can find websites dedicated to really clever sayings. You can find sayings from Confucius or from John Adams or from any number of different people. And if you work hard enough, you're going to find those sayings that you're looking for that are going to pretty much say amen to your own particular point of view. And so I think one of the sad things that has emerged from that kind of a way of thinking is that wisdom has become a commodity, just like other things that we have in this world are commodities, like milk, breakfast cereals, things like that. You have a preference for Cheerios, you get Cheerios. You have a preference for something else, you get something else. And unfortunately, I think sometimes wisdom finds that way into our thinking as well. Like, God helps those who help themselves. Not very biblical, but it's something that people say a great deal. And so, this morning, when we hear what our Lord says, we need to take it one step further. We need to be a little bit more aware of what exactly it is that he is saying. To give you a little bit of context, what we are concluding this morning is what scholars would call the Sermon on the Plain. Okay? You're very familiar with the Sermon on the Mount, right? That's the one in Matthew. Matthew 5 through 7, where you have the Beatitudes, you have the Lord's Prayer. Well, if you look in Luke, around the sixth chapter, you're also going to find there sayings that are somewhat similar. Some of them are quite different, but some of them are pretty similar. And so there is a parallel between the Sermon on the Mount and the Sermon on the Plain. Two different instances, different things that Christ is trying to teach his people. In the Sermon on the Mount, we hear, blessed are the poor in spirit. The Sermon on the Plain in St. Luke, you hear, blessed are the poor. Okay, not the poor in spirit. And so he's talking about a different condition. He's talking in one case of one's spiritual poverty, and the other he's really talking about someone's physical poverty and the eyes that we need to have as faithful people to those who are suffering so that we go and address their needs and make sure that they are cared for and loved and cherished and seen as made in the image and likeness of God so that we may ourselves actually have life. Because also in the Gospel of Luke, not only do you have the blessed are they who so, you also have the, but woe to those who are satisfied now, for they shall hunger. It's an interesting thing. In Luke, you have the negative side, not just the blessings, but, if you will, the curses. And so this morning, what Christ is trying to impress on the people who are hearing is the importance of making sure that not only do you say amen to the things that you agree with, but you listen very closely to what he has said, and that you go and you do the very things that he is talking about. This past Sunday, we had a series of readings that were extremely difficult for us to hold on to. Love those who despise you. What good is it to you to love those who love you? Even sinners do the same. Do good to those who do bad to you. Lend and expect nothing in return. It'd be really hard to be profitable in this world if you just gave and gave and gave and expected nothing in return. It's a really lousy way to run a bank. But it's an important way for us as Christians to live. We are called to love without any kind of regard for how that love is received. Because if we really think about it, when Christ himself came and lived on earth, and he taught, and he loved, and he healed, did he stop and say, well, I need to make sure that everyone's liking me before I continue? Did he, when he was on the cross, say, well, you know what, no one really likes me, so I give up? He didn't do that. In the midst of all the things that he went through, in the midst of all the people wagging their fingers and clucking their tongues and all of that as they would ride by and make fun of him, he didn't say, you're horrible, I hate you. He said, forgive them, for they know not what they do. And so this morning is sort of the seal on all of that image that we get, not just in the Sermon on the Plain, but in all the teachings that Christ has given us and all the things that he has done for us. It is the seal of that, that we are to hear what he says and we are to do it. And the image that he uses is the image of a foundation. Let me tell you what I've been doing over the last couple of days. 2 years ago, we discovered that, well, not discovered, we heard, we had the broken pipe in our basement. And so I had to do a little discovery because the person who built the basement bathroom put up a gigantic wall of brick. Okay, and these are not small bricks, these are big bricks. And so in order to find the leaky pipe, I had to break through the brick. So I did, found the leaky pipe, but when I found the leaky pipe, I also found a hole in our foundation. And so in the last couple of days, I've been taking down all the rest of the bricks so that I can find out exactly how bad the hole is. Why am I telling you this? Because the foundation itself is probably faulty, at least to a certain degree. The building that was done was built to cover up the flaw as opposed to just dealing with the problem. And so when we hear our Lord this morning talking about foundations, I thought, oh, well, I pretty much understand what he's saying there. Because when you don't take care of the foundation, when you don't make sure that the foundation is solid, then everything that is built upon that foundation will be vulnerable. And so we need to make sure, my brothers and sisters, that when we go out into the world, whether we choose to preach Christ, as the Apostle Paul says in the epistle this morning, or whether it is that we're just trying to make sense of our daily lives, however it is, we need that image of Christ inside of us, and we need that foundation of his teachings, of his mercy, of his love. We need those things to be the things on which we stand. Because the teachings of Christ, without living out the teachings of Christ, are merely wisdom that you find on a web page. But if you go and you are doers of his word, if you go and you hold on to the things that he has taught, not just in your head, but in your heart, where you've embraced it and done everything that you possibly can to live it out, then the words that will come out of your mouth to others will be seen not just as wisdom, but as words of salvation. They will be things on which they themselves can build their foundations, solidly on the foundation of Jesus Christ himself. And so that they are not just hearers of your words, but also doers of what Christ has to say through you. It is so important to my brothers and sisters, so important not just to listen and say, wow, that's really good. We must hold on to our foundations. We must hold on to the teachings and to the ministry that Christ has given us, and then we in turn echo, we reflect. I've said this before, but the word catechesis, that word that we think is instruction, really literally means to echo. And so that is exactly what we are called to do in this world. We are called to echo the love of God and the teachings that Christ has given us so that others may be blessed, not through us, but through God who has enlightened us. And so that when they do good, they may say, thank you, God. And when other people are blessed because of what they have done, likewise, they will give thanks to God. It's not easy, but at the same time, it's not really that hard. The world is an odd place. It is a place full of calendar of stories and conflicting stories and misdirection and violence and power and things that we really don't see in the church as things that are particularly virtuous. But when we listen to what Christ has said, and when we love as Christ has loved, and when we live as those who followed him have chosen to live, our foundations will be firm. And God will bless us. And through us, God will bless others. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, O God, forgive me, sinner.
Say with all our soul and with all our mind, let us sing.
Lord, have mercy.
O Lord Almighty, the God of our fathers, we pray thee, hearken and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Mercy on us, O God, according to thy great goodness, we pray thee, hearken and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
And we pray for Metropolitan Theodore Ticon, our Archbishop His Eminence Nathaniel, for priests, deacons, and all clergy, and for all our brethren in
Rome.
And we pray for this country, its president, for all civil authorities, and for the armed forces. Pray for Abbess Mother Christopher and the sister of this holy monastery for their health and salvation. And we pray for the blessed and ever memorable holy Orthodox patriarchs, and for the blessed and ever memorable founders of this holy monastery, and for the departed servants of God, the Archpriest Brasco, the Archpriest John, the Sister Sarah, Connie, Mila, Seraphim, Lynn, Maria, Flora, Christopher, Mary, Sally, Daryl, Anna, Paul, Rebecca, and Peter, and all our fathers and brethren, the Orthodox, are part of this life before us. Here in all the world, I asleep in the Lord.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Pray for mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, and visitation for the servants of God, the sister of this holy monastery, and all the faithful gathered here this day, especially for the servants of God, the Archpriest Andrew, the priest Anatoly, Barbara, Carola, Anka, David, Nikki, the infant Catherine, Mary, Ralph, Daria, Joseph, Lisa, Elizabeth, Anna, Effie, John, Emily, Marius, Kristen, Demetra, and the child that will be born of her in Georgia for the pardon and remission of their sins. Again, we pray for those who bring offerings and do good works in this holy and venerable temple, for those who labor, those who stand, and all the people here present, who await thy great and rich mercy.
Lord
our God, accept the prayers of the nation of thy servants, have mercy.
mercy on us according to the multitude of thy mercy. Send down thy bounties upon us and upon all thy people who wait the rich mercy that comes from thee. For thou art a merciful God and lovest mankind, and unto thee we ascribe glory, to the Father and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Unite them to the Holy Catholic and Apostolic Church and number them with thy chosen flock. That with us they may glorify thy honorable and majestic name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, and ever and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Catechumens, depart, depart, catechumens, all that are catechumens, depart, let a catechumen remain. Let us the faithful again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord. Thou hast saved us, and mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Wisdom, we thank thee, O Lord God of hosts, who was accounted as worthy to stand even now before thy holy altar and to fall down before thy compassion for our sins and for the errors of all thy people. Enable us also, whom thou hast placed in this thy service, by the power of thy Holy Spirit, blamelessly without offense, and the pure witness of our conscience, to call upon thee at all times and in every place. And hearing us, thou mayest be merciful unto us, and glory to the multitude of thy great goodness. For unto thee art due glory, honor, and worship to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Wisdom, again, and oftentimes we've been down before thee, O God, above us mankind, that looking down upon our petition, thou wouldst cleanse our souls and bodies from all defilement of flesh and spirit, and grant us to stand blameless and without condemnation before thy holy altar. Grant also to those who were with us, O God, growth in life and faith and spiritual understanding. Grant them to worship thee blamelessly with fear and love, to partake without condemnation of what mysteries, and to be accounted worthy of thy heavenly kingdom. That guarded always by thy might, we may ascribe glory unto thee, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, and ever and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Now, I will come with the desires from the place of the flesh, the word of your first master, the King of glory, for to minister to thee as a grand prophet, and foster, and even in the heavenly powers. Nevertheless, let us take the world around us, let us become able to change the alteration and the world.
Thank you.
May the Lord God remember in his kingdom, our metropolitan, his beatitude, Tikhon, and our archbishop, his eminence, Nathaniel. May the Lord God remember in his kingdom, our eldest mother, Christophora, and the sisterhood of this holy monastery. May the Lord God remember in his kingdom, our country, the United States of America, our president, our congress, our armed forces, and all our people. You and all Orthodox Christians, may the Lord God remember in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of God, the only begotten, begotten of the Father before all ages, light of light, true God, begotten, not made, of one essence with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven, and was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became man. And he was crucified for us under Pontius Pilate, and suffered and was buried. And on the third day he rose again, according to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sits at the right hand of the Father. And he shall come again with glory to judge the living and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. And in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spoke by the prophets, in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins, I look for the resurrection of the dead, and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us stand aright, let us stand with fear, let us attend the miracle of the oblation in peace. Thou and thy only begotten Son and thy Holy Spirit, and thou that was didst bring us from non-existence into being, and when we had all the way, raised us up again, and did not cease to do all things until thou hast brought us up into heaven, and hast endowed us with thy kingdom which is to come. For all these things we give thanks unto thee, and to the only begotten Son, and to thy Holy Spirit, for all the things of which we know and of which we know not, whether manifest or unseen. And we thank thee for this liturgy which thou hast deigned to accept at our hands. Though there stand by thee thousands of archangels, the hosts of angels, the cherubim, and the seraphim, six-winged, many-eyed, soaring aloft, borne on their wings. Singing the triumphal hymn, shouting, proclaiming, and saying,
Holy, 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 Lord, the Son of God, heaven and earth are full of
is thy glory. But so loved the world as to give thy only begotten Son, that all who believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. But when he had come and fulfilled all his dispensation for us, in the night in which he was betrayed, rather gave himself up for the life of the world, took bread in his holy and pure and blameless hands, and when he had given thanks and blessed it and held it and broken it, he gave it to his holy disciples and apostles, saying, Take, eat, this is my body which is broken for you, for the remission of sin. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, saying, Drink of it, all of you. This is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many, for the remission of sin. Remembering the same commandment and all those things which have come to pass, the cross, the tomb, the resurrection, and the third day, the ascension into heaven, the sitting at the right hand, and the second in glory is coming. Thine own, of thine own, we offer unto thee on behalf of all and for all.
apostles that have never taken off the most great. Make this bread the precious body of thy Christ.
Amen.
And that which is in this cup, the precious blood of thy Christ.
Amen.
Changing them by thy Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
That it may be to those who partake of it for the purification of the soul, for the remission of sins, the communion of thy Holy Spirit, for the fulfillment of the kingdom of heaven. Hold us towards even under the judgment and the condemnation. And again, we offer to this rational worship for all those who have fallen into the faith, ancestors, fathers, patriarchs, prophets, apostles, preachers, evangelists, martyrs, confessors, teachers, ascetics, and every righteous spirit that's included this life and faith. Especially for our most holy, most pure, most blessed, and glorious Lady Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary. Profitable for our souls and peace to the world, let us ask the Lord. give us peace, O Lord, and good defense before the great judgment seat of Christ, let us ask, O Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
Having asked for the unity of the faith, the communion of the Holy Spirit, let us commend ourselves and each other in all our life unto Christ our God.
We ask thee and pray thee and supplicate thee, make us worthy to partake of the heavenly and awesome mysteries of the sacred and spiritual table with a pure conscience, for remission of sins, for forgiveness of transgressions, for the communion of the Holy Spirit, for the inheritance of the kingdom of heaven, for boldness toward thee, but not of the judgment nor of condemnation. And make us worthy, O Master, that with boldness without condemnation, we dare to call upon thee, the heavenly God, his Father, and to say, compassion and love for mankind and the only begotten Son with whom thou art blessed, together with thine holy, good and life-giving Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Return to Jesus Christ, the God of all that lives and face from the throne of the glory of thy kingdom, come and sanctify us, so thou art sitting on high with the Father, and are here visibly present with us. And by thy mighty hand impart unto us thy most pure body and precious blood, and through us unto all thy people. Be gracious unto the sinner, and mercy more about thee, gracious unto the sinner, and mercy. God be gracious unto you, the sinner, and have mercy on me. Let us attend the holy things are for the holy.
Hallelujah.
believe also that this is truly thine own most pure body, and that this is truly thine own precious blood. Therefore, I pray thee, have mercy upon me, and forgive my transgressions, both voluntary and involuntary, of word and of deed, committed in knowledge and ignorance, and make me worthy to partake without condemnation of thy most pure mysteries, the remission of my sins, and of the life everlasting. Amen. Of thy mystical supper, O Son of God, accept me today as communion. For I will not speak of thy mystery to thine enemies, neither like Judas will I give thee a kiss, but like the thief will I confess thee. Remember me, O Lord, in thy kingdom. May the communion of thy holy mysteries be neither to my judgment nor to my condemnation, O Lord, but to the healing of soul and body. Amen.
In the fear of God, and with faith and love draw ye near.
Blessed is he that comes in the name of the Lord. God is on the heart, and us feel
worthy that our heart will be framed. It is not a wedding garment.
I shall be cast out by the evil, cleanse all by the fruits of our soul, and save you from the love for mankind.
Blessed be the name of the Lord, henceforth and forever. be the name of the Lord, henceforth and forevermore. Blessed be the name of the Lord, henceforth and forevermore.
Blessing of the Lord be upon you through his divine grace and love for mankind always, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Glory to thee, O Christ, our God, and our hope, glory to thee.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. In the name of the Lord, Father, give the blessing.
Grace our true God through the prayers of his most pure Mother, the Holy Chorus, and all honorable apostles of our Father, among the saints John Chrysostom and the Archbishop of Constantinople, the holy and righteous ancestor of God, Joachim and Anna, and of all the saints, mercy on us and save us, for as much as he is good and loveth mankind.